Hello, hello! In this video I want to go over the different models for Stable Diffusion. Now I know there's a ton of videos available on YouTube that cover this very same topic, so I don't want to beat a dead horse, and I will go over some comparisons as far as the outputs, but I also want to get a little bit more nuanced in what the differences are between all the models available, or at least some of the more popular ones, in order for you to understand which might be best for whatever your project is at hand. So let's go ahead and dive into it. So first off, Stable Diffusion 1.4 and 1.5 were released just over a year ago about. Both feature a 512 by 512 resolution and were trained on 860 million parameters. Now, one of the biggest differences between these models and some of the later models is the prompt technology, or kind of what's driving things. So OpenAI's Clip was used for these models. So that kind of results in that you have to write your prompts a little bit more differently with these older models. Now, a lot of folks kind of were upset with 2.0 and 2.1, feeling that it was lackluster compared to 1.4 and 5. It's because the prompts are largely different in the underlying technology, so you kind of have to change some of the habits on how you were generating images with these models. Now, as far as between 1.4 and 5, they are both very similar to one another. 1.4 tends to be a little bit more artistic driven, at least, you know, that's what I found, and that's also what other people have found as well too, where 1.5 is a little bit better for creating portraits or whenever you actually have people as a subject. Of course, we can go over and compare and look at the outputs here in just a bit. 2.0 and 2.1 were released later in the year, so just under a year ago now. They featured a large step up in resolution to 768. And as far as the parameters, I couldn't actually find a formal statement by Stability on how many parameters these models were trained on. Now, the bigger change for these models, though, is that they rely on Lion's OpenClip. So what that results in is different ways to create a prompt. So for example, in 1.4 or 5, you might have to say like highly detailed, 8K, photo, hyper-realistic, person standing, holding a flower. Like, these are all individual details that you'd have to put into your prompt to create a good image. Whereas the 2.x models, you could be a little bit more descriptive and expressive in your prompt. So you could actually just say a woman in a field holding a flower, and it can get pretty close to there. So that was kind of the big jump there. So a lot of people that had their old prompts in 1.x weren't, like, they couldn't really like just copy and paste it into these new models. Now I'll show you how you can kind of do that a little bit later on in the video. So you could get a little bit shorter prompts. I noticed that the colors within these models and the depth of the images tends to generate a little bit nicer as well. Stability actually came out and said 2.0, they were a little too aggressive on the not safe for work images. So there weren't a lot of people in the training data set. So the outputs for that might feature people from the 2.0 model aren't going to be nearly as good as 2.1. So if your workflow or your project that you're tackling includes generating people, you're best served by going with either 1.5 or 2.1, because those tend to generate better results. And then as far as Stable Diffusion XL, that is worlds apart with the previous model. So there's some really cool things that it has going there. We'll look at some of the outputs on later on in the video. So that was released just earlier this year in July 2023. Double the resolution of the first 1.x models at 1024 by 1024. The parameters is also massive too. Instead of only 860 million parameters, which I shouldn't say only, because that still is quite a bit, it features 3.5 billion parameters. Now, what's cool about Stable Diffusion XL is it's kind of backwards compatible, if you will, with earlier prompts if you are accustomed to the 1.4 or 5 models. So that actually features both Lion's OpenClip and then OpenAI's clip technology. So a lot of the prompts can carry over between the two of them. So you can put in shorter prompts if you want, or you can carry over your prompts and create really great, beautiful, high-resolution photos. Now, the biggest downside to this model is it's very hard to run on consumer-grade hardware. So for an example here is I'm using a MacBook Pro. It's got 16 gigs of RAM. It chokes on Stable Diffusion XL. I can't generate a single image with it. So you will need to have a dedicated graphics card in order to generate any sort of images, or use a rental GPU service, which I should make as a separate video, but there are options out there if you don't want to invest in a brand new machine. So changing gears to look at some of the outputs, I'll link to the GitHub repository in the description so you can see the prompts, the settings, and seeds, and so on. But we're just going to take a look at some of the pictures that were generated from these models. So with I mostly looked at one from each, so 1.5, 2.1, and XL. I'll in the people section a little bit later on, I'll look at some of the other models too, but for the most part, we're just comparing those three. So for cities, 1.5 generates some cool cities. I mean, the prompts on these are a little bit different, so it's a little bit of apples to oranges comparison here, but this is like a cyber futuristic city that was generated by 1.5. This one's by 2.1. This one, you can see it's extraordinarily detailed. Really cool visuals here. You can see this atmospheric depth going on here as it goes further back into the picture. Some nice, beautiful looking colors that look cohesive. And then, of course, Stable Diffusion XL. It just kind of looks worlds apart as far as like this depth. It's got a moodiness and an atmosphere to it. Everything, nothing looks like disfigured at all. Like, everything actually looks really sweet in the outputs of this model. So that was kind of with cities. Changing over to landscapes. Landscapes was a really interesting test too. So with 1.5, looks beautiful. I mean, if I saw this picture, I would not know that this is an AI generated picture at first glance. I mean, maybe if I started to look at it a little bit more, but like, this doesn't look too bad. Now, it does look a little flat. There's not that same depth, really, compared to the other models, but it looks pretty good. And then 2.1 also has a nice, beautiful, like, foggish look here, a nice popping colors. Of course, you know, the seed and the prompt is slightly different, but it still is. It generates a beautiful image. And then Stable Diffusion XL, again, it's just kind of rolls apart. Whenever you look at the depth of, like, say, this image compared to 1.5, you can really see where the colors are much more pleasing to the eye of this model. And, like, just the between, like, the fog here and the trees, it does. It just creates a really nice output. Now, portraits is the most telling for the models here. So 1.4... as you can see, in a lot of the older 1.x models, at least the, if you will, vanilla or base models here that have not been fine-tuned, anything that's kind of further away, so if you have like a full body or a wide-angle shot, there's a lot of disfigurement going on. So you might see extra limbs, or you'll see this face that's kind of like, it almost looks like the old troll effect in Photoshop. This one looks a little bit better. So I used Emma Watson as one of the prompts in this whole prompt. The reason why is because, you know, she was a famous celebrity and there's a lot of pictures of her face. So the model should be able to generate somewhat representative picture of her with that prompt. So I put that in there to try to help the prompt or Stable Diffusion generate a little bit better of an image. As you can see, 1.5 is a huge step in quality compared to 1.4 in some regards, especially this close-up. This looks really good. Again, of course, you still see some wonky disfigurement going on here in the eyes, or, you know, completely excluding the head in this one, and so on. It's not bad, but there's definitely a noticeable step up here. And then 2.0, which Stability proclaimed that it was not good at generating people. We see kind of, you know, even though it's a whole one version released later, there still is some disfigurement going on with some of these images. But the prompt in this image is a lot shorter than the previous images. resulting in a fairly good output, considering, you know, there's no in painting that has been done to these images. These are raw straight from the Stable Diffusion model. And then 2.1, we see a little bit better of quality as far as with people in particular. Of course, you know, there are mistakes because in the prompt there was the term yellow dress, which we could see all previous models nailed pretty well. This one, you know, it's not perfect. You see a blue dress here. But like the output of this image here is the quality is really good. I mean, there's not really much whenever it comes to any sort of weirdness going on. Of course, this one, it's really far away, but you can kind of see that it's not nearly as clear. And then Stable Diffusion XL with a very short prompt created really beautiful like depth to the images and all of the outputs here. There still is a little bit of weirdness if you look at each of these, but like it's definitely not as bad as, you know, say 1.4, which, you know, for comparison, was kind of all, you know, these are a lot different than what you would see at the compared to Stable Diffusion XL. So you could really see where these the increase in parameters and then even the prompting is much different between these models. Now let's shift gears. So as far as going between the models, so there's a couple ways you can do this. Is so 1.x used that different technology, like I said, whenever it came to prompts. So there's this one thing on Hugging Face that can help you kind of translate an older prompt into a newer 2.x prompt. Basically, it's kind of like a bridge between these two models. So you can drop in your image here and click submit, and then it'll go ahead and develop a descriptive output that should generate a fairly similar, it won't be a one-for-one match, but a fairly similar image. Now, if you're using Automatic 1111 Stable Diffusion web user interface, they also have that option to interrogate a clip here. And so you can go ahead and drop it in your image into this block here and then interrogate a clip, and it will also generate a description based on the image. Of course, if you want to know more about the different models, you can head over to the stability.ai website, and they have all sorts of write-ups on each of the releases. Now, as far as when it comes to downloading the models, so Stable Diffusion, it's really confusing, especially for a beginner, because I was there not too long ago, as well as probably you are, is that there's lots of different releases, and what really adds to it too is that sometimes Stable Diffusion or Stability partnered with different organizations, so you don't know, it's not, you don't always go to the same place to download the models or the checkpoints. So for example, they partnered with Runway, which is its own company, to release Stable Diffusion 1.5. And so to download it, you would have to go ahead and go to the files and versions, and then you'd see the files here. Now, you can see there's actually a lot of different files. You got two 4.27 gig files, as well as a 7.7 gig files, two of those as well, too. Generally speaking, you always want to download the safe tensors files. Now, in this case, since Stability is a trusted organization that's not a malicious actor, you could download the checkpoint file and it would work just fine, just like the safe tensor. The difference is that checkpoint files might have import statements which could execute malicious code on your machine, whereas the safe tensor files do not have that potential to inject malicious code. So if you were to download this, then you have to decide between the pruned EMA only and then just the pruned. And as you can see, there's a noticeable difference as far as the size. So we did a little bit of digging, and I write this up in a blog post over on the website here, is that you can see that EMA stands for Exponential Moving Average, which means there is more weight on the most recent values. So this is commonly used to reduce noise and improve accuracy. So that was helpful understanding what EMA means. And then I did a little bit of further digging, and this scientific director, or I'm sorry, research director with Stability AI had actually noted that you should always use the EMA weights for generation. So, with that being said, if you just want to generate images or outputs with Stable Diffusion models, use the EMA only checkpoint or safe tensors files. You don't have to download this larger file. While these would work, the generations will likely be better with these two. Now, for Stable Diffusion 2.0 or 2.1, you would also download the EMA pruned checkpoint or safe tensors file, which is a little bit bigger, but you'd just go ahead and download it. And then this one was released via Stability AI, which is the folks that are making the Stable Diffusion models. But with these files, you would have to actually include a config file, which Stability has on their GitHub repository. If you go to the Stability AI Stable Diffusion repo, you can download this YAML file. So basically, you would download this and rename it to the same file name as the V21768 EMA pruned. So you would have to include that alongside with your model. So whenever you're done there, it would look something like this. So if you had the checkpoint, and then you make the YAML the same exact name. Now, outside of the base models that we talked about today, it's important to talk about fine-tuned models. So there's websites like CividAI where you can actually download models that people have fine-tuned and trained on more images that generate breathtaking outputs with very short prompts that are often much better quality than the baseline Stable Diffusion models. So for example, if we take a look at this first one here, we can see that it was trained on Stable Diffusion 1.5, yet the quality of the images are quite breathtaking. So for example, if we take a look at this output that features Tom Cruise, we can go ahead and click the eye here, and you can see how short the prompt is, as well as the negative prompt, and then and you can just generate it yourself. You can just sign up for an account on this website, and then you can just go ahead and download here. And then you would just add it to your Stable Diffusion folder within the models directory if you're using Automatic 1111. So if you want to kind of create different types of images, there's lots of options out there for you outside of the baseline Stable Diffusion models. Of course, if you have any questions, you can drop a line in the comment section below. Otherwise, also join the Discord where I can just chat with you there and try to answer any questions that you might have. Now, if you like the video, please hit that thumbs up and consider subscribing. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was helpful in kind of understanding all the differences out there when it comes to Stable Diffusion. Have a good day.